Mr. Brokaw.
Nice of you.
Well, you look like $1 million tonight. You get yourself a little Italian suit going there, and you look great.
Look like $1 million, 1/20th of your annual salary.
Ah. Good one, Tom. Congratulations on the, I'm reading, I'm at home on Sunday, and I'm looking through the New York Times, and I see what looks like a full-page ad announcing that your daughter is getting married, or was married over the weekend. Congratulations.
It was a great moment in our lives. Married a doctor.
Married a doctor. That's good.
And she is a doctor.
She is a doctor as well.
Works out very well. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Graduated from Dartmouth Medical College 1 week, got married the next.
Was this the most exciting, most nerve-wracking, most pride-filled weekend of your recent life?
Oh, sure. It was a big moment. We have three daughters and an extraordinarily well-organized mother and wife who got all this working early on, and it went off swimmingly, as they say. We had a wonderful time.
Any last-minute traumas, any anxieties? What was your role? You, of course, give your daughter away. What did you have to do?
There are other roles as well, which is mostly to stand in the corner and not make any contributions of any kind except to write the check when they hand them to you. And then at 3 o'clock Saturday afternoon, 2.5 hours before the wedding, I had the crucial role, which was to wash the getaway car. Uh-huh. That's how I was spending my time.
Now that's the good thing about you. As I watch the news, what is it, the evening news, the nightly news?
The nightly news.
I don't know. I don't have a head for details. I can imagine you giving us the news, factual, up-to-date, everything we need to know, and I also can imagine you washing your car.
And washing yours as well, if you'd like. I mean, you drive
a Come on down and wash a few this weekend.
In fact, I'll be doing, to pay for the wedding, I'll be washing lots of cars on the weekend.
And how about the families? Had you known your son-in-law's family before?
No, I had not before. And, I have a low threshold for tolerance for people that I don't get along with real well, mm-hmm. and they eliminated any concerns that I had whatsoever. They're mm-hmm. from a small town in Oklahoma, Claremore, not unlike where the Brokaws come from, in South Dakota. His dad is a retired high school coach. His mother's a librarian. Wonderful people.
Nice people.
We get along very well.
Anybody get into the punch hard at the reception?
Yeah, lots. Lots did.
But and there was no hair pulling fist fights?
No, none of that. It worked. It is, I think, a real passage in any father's life. And as I turned to make the walk down the aisle, it did seem like an out-of-body experience. I'm not old enough to do this. I've watched this before. Yeah.
Now, you have two other daughters.
I do.
Soon to be of marrying age, I guess.
Well, they are. Yes, in fact, that's a possibility. And after this weekend and after what we were able to do for Jennifer, we now have a kind of two-word mantra for the other two. Las Vegas.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot of weekend.
See you, Tom. Very, very thoughtful. Now, every time you're on the show, it seems to me like you have just come back from a rather exotic, exciting adventure, some vacation, or are planning one. Where are you now? Are you
Another
just back or getting ready to go?
Back in the third world again, just back from Nepal. I spent 3 weeks traveling and then doing a trek.
How do you get to Nepal?
A long airplane ride to Tokyo, change planes, ride to Bangkok, spend the night, get up early the next morning and get on a flight to Kathmandu, and then spend the night there and then take a charter to a remote a mountain valley where we jumped off the charter and started walking long ways uphill for 5 days to get to a new area, or an area that just opened up called Beaumontant.
Mm. You stay at the Marriott there? Ready to go on and tell people the news of the evening, aren't you?
I am indeed, and we'll miss you around the building for many reasons.
Really?
We really will.
I honestly don't get the sense people will miss me.
No, not true at all. Among other reasons is that we get to watch you at 5:30 in the evening instead of having, now you're going to make us stay up until 11:30.
But you'll come and see us at the new show. You can. I mean, the network will let you come visit us there, won't
they? Well, if you invite me, of course I will, but it's cross-town traffic and all that.
Fighting
my way through that mob of people.
You can't Kathmandu, you can't make it up to 53rd and Broadway. Man!
Well, if you arrange for good shopping just outside my tent.
There's wonderful shopping outside.
Listen, the maintenance people here stopped me on the way, and you're not going to get the security deposit back.
I haven't taken very good care of the place.
They said something about that life-size Vanna White inflatable doll melting into the shag rug or whatever it was. I don't know.
Tom, let's knock off the hijinks here and get serious. Tell us about your first, we're talking about trips and New York. Tell us about your first trip to New York City. A young boy from North Dakota, like there's a difference, what the hell.
South Dakota, we say the only good thing to come out of North Dakota was Highway 81. They don't like that
at all. Yeah, they sure, yeah. So you come to the city as, how old a kid were you?
I was 17.
First experience with New York City.
I was governor of Boy State in South Dakota, and I was asked to come in and appear on a quiz program with the governor of the state at that time, Joe Foss, who was a World War II hero and first commissioner of the American Football League and all that. And we came to appear on something called Two for the Money.
Mm-hmm. This was a popular quiz show of
it
the
was.
Day?
It was. Herb Schreiner and summer, Sam Levinson. Mm-hmm. Herb Schreiner's an old Hoosier.
That's right.
Sam Levinson was running. Anyhow, they put me up at this Fleabag Hotel over in Times Square somewhere.
Now, what was the name of the hotel?
I think it's still there, so I'm not sure.
I know, that's right.
It. Probably have very good counsel, you know. I'm not going to say what the name of it. It's still there.
Would be great. A rundown, dumpy hotel in Times Square sues you.
Right.
Mr. News, I would love that. That would be great.
Yeah, but, if you're going to have that happen, why not have them sue you for something that, has a little appeal to it?
Yeah, uh-huh. You still have an account there, don't you, Tom?
Yeah, I do. anyhow, I go over there and I meet with the writers. We do all this stuff, and I'm kind of semi-paralyzed with fear because it's live television in those days, and you got to go on and do this thing. I figured it's probably going to be about politics, and I was a junkie even then. And this is going to, I think I could get
this. Was your meat. You knew all there was to know about
politics.
Everyone.
And so right before the program begins, the guy comes in, very nervous. I remember spaghetti stains all over his shirt because he had his dinner, obviously, in his lap, and he said, well, we're here on a budget, and click, here's the stopwatch, here are the questions. Statute of limitations must have run out of this money.
So he gives you
fixed.
The...
It was fixed to the hill.
That's right. Before a certain time, they were most of them rigged, weren't
right, they?
Right,
they were.
Somebody
and
blew the whistle
we
on them.
Could have made, we could have broken the bank, because they were asking these kind of sappy political questions, all of which we knew, and we had to build in laugh lines and take time, as opposed to this program.
Hey, what are you saying, Tom? What the hell? But now, wait a minute. It's the governor of your home state.
Well,
And you're the governor of little boy state, your little kiss-up job there.
Right. And total tank. No moral barometer whatsoever.
Is that right?
Whatever it takes, we'll do it. Absolutely. $612? I'm very happy.
But now listen. Now, I think you can see if we superimpose this over a young candidate from Arkansas, this kind of thing had shown up on that man's record, oh, my God, we'd never heard the end of it, would we?
No, I probably not. Yeah. And that's what's kept me from being president of the United States.
Thank you for everything. I'm Brokaw. We'll be right back after station identification. Thank you.